for your many blessings, God. We thank you, dear God, just for your grace this morning, God. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your love and kindness, God. As we assemble this morning, dear God, we just want you to be glorified, God, in all that we say, dear God, in all that we do. We pray, dear God, that we just lift you up this morning, God, because we know it's not about us, God, but it's all about you. And we pray this prayer in Jesus' name. Our inspirational message this morning is going to come from Isaiah, the 6th chapter. And we just want to talk about verse number 1. Isaiah, the 6th chapter, verse number 1. And it says, in the year that King Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up. His train filled the temple. In the year that King Uzziah died, in that particular year, when King Uzziah died, Isaiah is saying that he saw the Lord. King Uzziah was the 10th king of Judah, and he reigned about 52 years. King Uzziah was king after his father died. And then when King Uzziah died, his son became king. Now we know all throughout the history, as long as there were good kings, Israel profited. And when there were bad kings, the children of Israel did those things that were displeasing in the sight of God. But Isaiah says, in the year that King Uzziah was a king that respected God. He was a king that reverenced God. So during the year that when King Uzziah was king, there was prosperity, there was peace, there was what we might call all of the people prospered. And they got along well with one another. And so Isaiah is saying here, during this particular year, when there was no more prosperity, you see, sometimes God got to move those things out of the way for us to see what we need to see. Because Isaiah is saying here, it wasn't until King Uzziah died that I was able to see the Lord high and lifted up. King Uzziah represented some props that were in the way of Isaiah seeing what he needed to see. And my God, isn't there today those things in our sight, in our vision, that prevent us from seeing what we need to see about God? God didn't change when King Uzziah died. He was still the same God. But it's saying that Isaiah didn't see him until King Uzziah moved off the scene. There's something wrong with that picture, y'all. Because he's saying King Uzziah died in that year, but in that year I also saw the Lord. He said he was high and lifted up. He's always been high and lifted up. That's the way he's supposed to be in our lives, right? High and lifted up. But as long as we have those things in our vision that's distracting us from seeing what we need to see about our holy God, it prevents us from seeing what we need to see about God. And so here it is. God moved King Uzziah off the sea. And when he moved him off the sea, Isaiah says, I also saw the Lord. I also saw the Lord. What is it in our lives that is preventing us from seeing God high and lifted up? What does he have to remove from our lives so that we can see God just as we need to see him? What are those things that preventing us from having that image of God that as Christians we should have? Isaiah said, I saw him. I saw him high. And I saw him lifted up. He said he was sitting on a throne high and lifted up. And his train, it just filled the temple. His robe was flowing. Isaiah could see the majesty of the king. Not the earthly king. But he said, I could see the majesty of the divine king. Can you see his majesty this morning? What are those things that's keeping us from seeing God the way we really need to see him? What are those things that's keeping us from doing what we need to do for a holy God that's high and lifted up? That's what Isaiah's message was. And you know, in this particular chapter here, he said, above God, there were seraphims. He said, and not only were there seraphims, he said, each one had six wings. With two wings, that they covered his face. And with two, he covered his feet. And with two, they flew. He's talking about the majesty of a holy God. He said, then one of them cried to the other one. He said, holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. Holy, holy, holy. Do we view God as really being holy? I mean, do we have a right perspective of who God is? Because you know, there's anything and everything that stop us from viewing God the way we really should view him. There's any and everything that stop us as Christians. I'm talking Christian people. I'm not talking about people of the world. Because people of the world do what the world does. But Christians are called to be different. We're supposed to view God different. Everything and anything are not supposed to stop us from being who we are supposed to be. From walking the way we are supposed to walk. But Christians, we have a problem. If it looks like, I didn't say it is. I say if it looks like the weather is bad outside, guess what we do? We going back to bed. If it looks like we got another event coming up, we going to the event and we're not going and doing what God has called us to do as Christians. If he is holy, and he is majesty, and he is the one who has given his life for us, shouldn't we have the same view of God that was given here in Isaiah, the sixth chapter? If we view him as the majestic one, then we ought to have a fresh perspective of what majesty looks like. We don't treat majesty like we treat any old thing. If God is all that we proclaim as Christians that he is, we have to do better. Amen. We have to live better. We have to speak better. Yeah. We have to serve better. We just have to do better. Amen. Because you see, this is what Isaiah is saying. He said, I saw all of this. When God moved King Uzziah off the sea, I was able to get a clearer perspective of who God was. And if that is something that is keeping us from getting a clearer perspective of who God really is, we need to move that thing out of our lives. Because Isaiah is saying it just wasn't until then that I could see. 52 years King Uzziah had reigned. And you mean to tell me in 52 years Isaiah could not see God? Because King Uzziah was blocking his vision? We have been Christians for many years. What have we allowed to block our vision? God, we say, the scriptures say, God is the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. And if he's the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore, he has not changed. Nothing about him has changed. Nothing about him will change according to the scripture. So we should be still walking the same way we walked when God saved us. When he pulled us out the miry clay, and the joy that we had when we first received him, and the things that we did when we first received him, we should still be walking that same walk. We should still be talking that same talk. We can't be Christians for 42 and 50 years and we don't see the majesty of our God. Christians, we have to do better. We have to walk, and I'm not just singling anybody out. I'm talking about as Christians. We are called to be different. The world has to see us different. We should be light to a dark world. We have to tell a lost world about a Savior. We have to bring in. Time is winding up, y'all. I know we can see it. Oh, yeah. We can see it winding up. Yes. And so if we are called to live better and do better, this is no time for us to slack off. We got to run more with haste now than we ever did.
Yeah, Lord.
We see what's happening in this world. So whatever it is, that's preventing us from seeing God as we are supposed to see him. Remove that. Pray and ask God to remove that thing from our lives and our sight so we can get the perspective that we need to have on our God. So we can do those things the way we are supposed to do them. And we can stop allowing things to stop us from being all that God has called us to be. As Christians, Bible study should be filled up on Wednesday when we got a fresh perspective of his holiness. Discipleship, I ought to be filled up because we are preparing to go out into the world to tell the world about our God. And we can't do that if we don't know him. We can't do that if we don't come in and fill up and learn about him and get ready to go back out into the world. We can't sit on the sidelines any longer. We got to get out there. We got to get our vision straight So if you're in a position like Isaiah was, see God in all the majesty that he is. See him. Get a fresh perspective on who he is and what he has accomplished. He's the creator, but he's not all just creator. He's sustainer. He's our God. He's everything we need him to be. And we ought to be out there telling that to somebody. We know somebody that is everything you will ever need. And that's my message this morning. See God. See him high and lifted up in everything that we do.
Thank you, Lord.
Portray that. That's how our perspective is of God. Father, we thank you this morning. We praise you, God. We magnify your name, God, because you're worthy to be praised this morning, God. Help us, dear God, to see you in all your majesty, God. Help us to not only see you, dear God, but live like you're king of our lives, God. See you, dear God, as ruler of our lives, God. And God, we'll be so ever careful to give your name the glory, the honor, and the praise, which is due you. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Mm-hmm.